Yes. I don't have no more fries left, though.
You're welcome, babe.
Hey, y'all. I'm at work.
So, I'm gonna check on, so when I have, like, my rolls, corned beef and stuff like that for the next day at work, I have to cook it off the day before. So tomorrow they got roast beef, so I have to cook it off today. For my dinner tomorrow. Good seasons on there. Seasons you can smell, by the way. So this is what I cook for tomorrow. But I'm gonna taste test it tonight to make sure it's gonna be good for them tomorrow. So we're gonna make a roast beef sandwich. Y'all ready? Piece of this beef. No. You sure? Got 8 packages.
I got a lot of salt on there.
Girl, you know I can put that good seasoning on there. I don't give a salt. I'm gonna put salt on my shirt. I'm not daddy. Hey to my subscribers. One of my coworkers, y'all. Calling my baby daddy.
Hello.
Man. y'all said no. Jeez. I already cut me some meat off earlier, so you see how they look. This is how I look. I love fat too, y'all. Fat piece on there. You're welcome. So. Tomatoes, lettuce, hot peppers. What you looking for? Now this is the sandwich part. Like I said, I got tomatoes, cheese, jalapenos, mustard, mayo, Italian dressing. I'm gonna put that up on there like that. And we're gonna put that on here. See it? We're gonna flip the tissue paper over. And we're gonna have to. And I got the potato, which is a pretty filler. Plate. Alright, look, I'm over here making me a lunch. Potatoes, cut them up.
In the video.
Okay, y'all, so I cut them up. Give me 1 second, okay? I'm gonna pause it. Okay, so now we see it dripping with the sauce and the potatoes. You have to leave the peeling on it. Again, I'm just gonna put some little ketchup on it. I wanted to put some sour cream on it, but that's going too much. And I eat a lot of bread, y'all, so y'all must need to make sandwiches out of every thing you see me eat. Sorry, don't judge. Okay, we're gonna throw all this extra stuff away and clean off my table. Put these 30 styles up. I can't do it no more. All this to the break room. I got my food, my Dr. Pepper, I'm putting it in my bag, my tag with the thing in the bag, my little bag stuff, everything in there. Wait a minute. That Dr. Pepper without no biggity ice. Okay, now come on. We're gonna go taste this. We're gonna go taste out this roast beef sandwich or why? We're gonna go to the break room, y'all. I'm taking y'all to the break room with me. And we're here. Okay, I'm glad it's a little clean around here. I'm gonna sit this down. Ooh. I wish I could listen to some music. Getting a little comfortable, y'all. Excuse me. Okay. Get that fupa out the way. Excuse my fupa. That's a good fupa, though. That's good fupa. Okay. So y'all, that's it. me show y'all. A very special lady. Y'all, I love dark pop. So y'all will always see me drinking either Dr. Pepper, root beer, or RC. I don't really like Pepsi. Even though it's dark, it just don't taste like these three. It's my time to wipe my hands. Because we ran out of napkins. But anyway, y'all. Okay. I'm going to talk some shit to y'all while I eat. And we're going to make... Okay, now we're going to turn into his little mukbang. So this is a... This is a homework made pot roast beef. Meat, but I turned it into a sandwich and I made the sandwich into rye bread. Got jalapenos, tomatoes, lettuce, cheese, Italian sauce, mustard, and mayo. And then I got potatoes cut with the peel on it that I steamed with a little ketchup on it. With my Dr. Pepper, as I showed y'all, my cup. And now we're gonna mukbang. Put my tablet on, see what y'all doing around the world. In these countries, cities, states, and stuff, while I talk stuff to y'all. I should have put sour cream on the potatoes. I love potatoes, y'all. Yeah, These potatoes are so good. I'm telling you. So, y'all, what y'all doing today? It's Saturday. Yeah, I was going to say, everybody been sending shouts out. So, I got to send some shouts out to y'all. You got to fuck with me. I got to fuck with y'all. So, I'm gonna send a shout out to Nieces World. Hey, boo. Y'all go check these pages out too. Even I know some of y'all came to join my family, which I thank you and I appreciate y'all from some of these people's channels. But if y'all some of my people that came with me when I came, then y'all go check these ladies out. So, Nieces World, Life Talk with Liz. Mirror to Marijuana. I got 5 on it. Blah My Eats. Miss BB. Kendall's Corner. She be preaching, y'all. She got the word, Kendall's Corner. Family Dream. The Family Dream over there at their house. And with that family over there.
You be cracking up, rolling on the fucking floor, hard, her family, everybody participates. They do a lot of stuff. Their content is good. Miss True Redbone. The Scott Squad. It's a few people, y'all. Mama Moya. I like Mama Moya in her accent. It's a couple more people. If I missed y'all, don't worry. I'm gonna be doing some more shouts out and just be, you know, letting people know how y'all content is good and what all y'all be doing and talking about. Which is everybody that I mentioned has very great content. Very great. They letting you in their everyday life with their families and their kids and their jobs and just all that. This sandwich so big, y'all, I can't even really pick it up. Excuse me, y'all, if it fall apart. Oh my gosh, you can taste that seasoning. It's so good. Miss Official. Lakeside. Lakeside is so fucking hilarious, y'all. Definitely go visit that family over there. And you know, we just all family that work with me with open arms, so I'm just showing and spreading the love back. There's a few more. As I can think of right here. But yeah, y'all go check them pages out. Even if y'all do be on them pages and channels, just remain with us. We all family. We all, it's all love. At the end of the day, we all here for each other, supporting each other. And most of them that I named been my sense ones since day one out here in these streets. So I definitely support them. Definitely. Oh my God, y'all. I wish I could just get all y'all a sandwich. Let me see. It's another couple who showed me love out here in these streets, and I just want to return to the love, which is Fluff Family Skits. Yeah, y'all. So what y'all doing though on this Excuse me, y'all. I'm just making a mess. I'm making a mess, y'all. And it's Saturday. It's my gap birthday weekend. So we're just probably gonna be hanging out. I might set y'all with me. It depends on what we're doing. These jalapenos be so good. Especially in each bite. Yeah, I see how I gotta keep putting this sandwich out back in place. Mm-hmm. Just like that fupa right there. All that bread and potatoes I eat. But that's okay. So good. And then that pop, just put it right on the spot. And then I got cilantro on there. And it's good that I'm eating now because, like I said, I'm probably gonna hang out for a minute. And I'm finna be drinking on some yak. Hennessy, that is. No wine in the night, baby. We doing it hard. We doing it hardcore, baby. And I drink my drink straight, raw. No juice, no water, no chaser. This is some straight fat girl shit. But hey, I'm a fat little girl. I'm acting like a little fucking kid now. Look at all the shit on my shirt. Jesus. So y'all drinking? What y'all doing? Y'all smoking? What y'all doing right now, y'all? What y'all doing? Y'all look at this video as I'm asking, what are you guys doing? I'm glad y'all came to fuck with me for a minute or two. I ain't gonna hold y'all. Cause I wanna come see what y'all doing. I just want y'all to see my little sandwich and what I cook for my residents for tomorrow. I'm gonna taste it. And I want y'all to come along with me. I can spend some time with me. And I appreciate it. Y'all hit the like, comment, subscribe, put me on the bell, yo. My staff was in there trying to let them taste the meat that y'all can see. They like it. I know you fucking lying. Y'all, I was downtown a couple days ago. This right. And I don't know if y'all familiar with the R. Kelly thing that been going on with the grills and the courts and everything. So I ended up seeing Ezreal and Jocelyn, Joycelyn, whichever one her name is. They were just out and about shopping and taking pictures and stuff. Look at them. Happy. Look like they got no problems. No worries, no nothing there. They stay in the Trump Towers down here in Chicago. You know y'all know this, y'all already follow the story or whatever, but they was out kicking it off for her. They ain't like they was worried about nothing. And I know every court day I be seeing on the internet and stuff that they attend all his court dates and everything. He tried to get conjugal visits or whatever, which is the visit that you have where you can lay up and have sex with whoever you can come or invite or whatever. They denied it. Which is, okay, come on. We know you are Kelly, but now you're pushing it. You already know a situation you wish you want to invite them to come and have conjugal visits with you. I just knew that was going to be, I know you fucking lying. The fuck? Okay. But I knew they was going to deny it though. But I seen them. They didn't look broke. As they say, R. Kelly is broke. R. Kelly is not no broke. That is some shit they want to feed us in the media. If you were asking me. Because they were shopping good, looking good. Because of the most expensive clothes and bags. So, they ain't look like the news or the media turned them out to be. Shit, they was living life. And to the fullest. I think their parents was just money hungry. Because who turned your daughters over at a concert and leaving with a grown-ass man? That was a money thing. Because think about it. We didn't hear about it. None of these years. For 10 years. And then they talking about R. Kelly broke. We never heard in the industry, the media, the news, the magazines, the newspapers that R. Kelly was broke. Up until this bullshit happened with these girls. Now I'm gonna call him broke. Yeah. They doing him like they did motherfucking Bill Cosby. Michael Jackson and Prince. This is my opinion. I'm full as hell. And it's good. I ain't gonna be no more good for the rest of my work shift, y'all. I'm fat. I'm full. That was on point. I seasoned it real good. They gonna love it. I hope I have enough extra left over because I know they gonna want seconds. Was on your white bread. You're even no. I don't even know. Beyonce getting ready to go on tour, y'all. Couple months. Y'all like Beyonce? I'm sure y'all do. I like Beyonce too, but I went to one of the concerts. Maybe two. And I don't think I'll go to another concert. And I'm especially paying from motherfucking $150 to $250 tickets. The reason why I say it is because now I've been to Rihanna concert, I've been to R. Kelly concert, Cat Williams comedian, Mike Earp, Kevin Hart, we went to Future before, Jay-Z, a lot of people, Migos. So anyway, with that being said, with the names I just said, nah, I would go to Cardi B. I ain't got a chance to see Cardi B or Nicki Minaj. But with them being said, I would go see them two ladies too because I know about them. They let me in. They let me see their life. They let me see how they live. They raised their babies with us. They didn't hide it. Everything they go through is in the industry. It's in the news. We see it. We know. You know. So I would spend my money for a person that's letting me in. I know something about, you know what I'm saying, versus, did she have that baby, or did she have a surrogate, you know what I'm saying? Because people said she had the baby, people said she had a surrogate, like, damn, who is Becky with the good hair? Where the fuck Becky with the good hair come from? Was Jay-Z cheating with Becky? Don't know that either. We just heard one sentence about it, and boom, bam. Why was Solange and Jay-Z and Beyonce in the elevator fighting shit? Don't nobody know. Bummer. Don't nobody know that either. So it's like, she don't let people in her life, and then she come around to Chicago when it's income tax time, because she know all the girls, the black women and shit, want to see her and come stand in formation and shit with her in the bars, which is okay, fine and dandy, but I won't be doing that no more. She always come around income tax time to everybody's city and shit. Like, okay, y'all, it's gonna be January, February, March. Think you take income tax around the world? Let me go. You won't get none wrong. I work the motherfucking income tax this year. Until you let me in, Miss B. The Carter, The Rock, girl. I ain't meddling with it. And then every time she goes to a concert or have a concert, it's the same damn thing. She's just doing it a different way. Songs in different orders. She wear the same little shorts, the same little boots, the same goddamn sweater. And when the light hit, it just turned a different motherfucking color. Oh my God, B. I want to fuck with you. I like you. Don't get me wrong. I love Beyonce. I like her music. All that Jay-Z, Blue Ivy, the other little baby. See, what's the other little baby name? I don't even know the other little baby name, but the twins. But I like her. I just don't like how she don't let us in like most of the other celebrities who I feel like they let me in, and I know things about them, and I wouldn't have to question because it's out there and I already know. I will go buy a CD. I'll buy a movie if they play in it. I'll buy a mixtape. I'll buy a DVD. I'll buy a bootleg. You know what I'm saying? I'll buy the music. I'll download it on all the iTunes and all that stuff. You feel me? I'll go to a concert. But that be? Sorry, be eyes. Don't cut my... Don't chop me up. Don't cut my neck off. That's just how I feel. sorry. Look at my shit. Like a kid, somebody at my kitchen door, I can hear out there. Or maybe not. They jamming over there in that department. They listen to Michelle A. If you want to turn off the lights, let's get one thing understood. If you want to make love to me, you got to do it good. Cause I'm a hell of a woman, and for you it takes a hell of a man. So don't you dare turn off the lights, just unless you understand. Boom, boom. Oh, I'm gonna go home and watch that movie. I like the Mission Lay. What was that? Surviving Compton. I like the Tupac movie, All Eyes on Me. And I like the Dr. Dre now. Come. My nigga Dre said, E, why don't you do it? He said, I ain't no rapper, man. I'm out here in these streets. I get money. Next thing you know, he back there like, cruising down the street in my 6'4". They like, what the fuck? That nigga hit the door on the last one. Cool her down the street in my 6'4". Now, okay, y'all, I'm done. I held y'all long enough just to come see what my little bullshit was about today on this Friday. On this Saturday, see, I told y'all I'd be lost in my days. I need some days to myself, some me time, some mommy time, some Holly time. I need some uncut time shit. I'm always lost in my day. That's why I'm always at fucking work. I live at work and at home. I live at work and I visit home. Thank you for coming back. Fucking with Holly. Hollywood Uncut. Like, comment, subscribe. Hit that. Boom, boom. Hit that bell. Boom. Bust that bitch for me. Ring it. I know y'all like me a little, so, hey, I'll be back. Enjoy.